Sziasztok! Itt van az Ilona néni, és egy pár ajánlatot adok, tanácsot, hogy hogyan kell a naplót betölteni. És kezdjünk a tetején. Itt látható, hogy azt szeretném az első vonalon, hogy beírjuk, hogy milyen nap van, szóval hétfő, kedd, szerda, csütörtök, péntek, szombat vagy vasárnap. Szóval azt mondjuk, hogy ma hétfő. És akkor folytatjuk azon a vonalon, beírjuk, kiírjuk teljesen betűkkel, ne használjuk a számokat, mert azt akarjuk, hogy magyarul tanuljuk, gyakoroljuk az írást. Szóval a következő a vonalon azt írjuk, hogy a hónap, mi a hónap, ma április, és ma április 20-a. Szóval nem április 20, hanem 20-a. If you look, I'm going to now review what I've just said in Hungarian. Hello, just so that there's some clarity as to what I would like to see in your daily journal entries. So at the top, what you'll find is the top line. I'd like you to spell out the day of the week. Hétfő is Monday. Today is Monday. And so I write ma hétfő. Today is Monday. Now you'll see a comma. And what I want now in that line, what you'll write is the month and the date. And I want you to write it out, spell it out. I don't want you to write April 20 using the 2 and the 0. I want it spelled out and properly. So remember, we practiced ordinals. These are the egy, első, kettő, második, három, harmadik, négy, negyedik, right? It always has that ik, except for one and two, always has that special ending, which makes it an ordinal. You're going to be using the ordinals when we write the date this way. Április huszadik. Hús is 20. Huszadik is the 20th. But you write an A at the end. Április huszadika. Okay, again, that A might be an E in other areas. So try to practice that. I'll try to, not try, but I will post in Quizlet some flashcards so that you can practice how to write dates in this way. And so, but do your best, and that's the whole point of this exercise, is that by the time we get to May 30th, you're going to be keeping this journal. You have enough pages to get you through the whole rest of our school year to the end of May. So I want you by the end of May to have learned the days of the week. If you fill out this top line every day, do your best. By the end of May, you'll know how to do this. You'll know the days of the week with no problem. You'll know what day is Monday in Hungarian, hétfő, or Tuesday, kedd. And you'll also know how to at least write April and May, because you're going to write it frequently, as well as how to write out then the date, the huszadika, huszon egyedike, etc., which is 21st. So, all right, that's the first line. A következő sor a reggel. És itt azt szeretném, hogy megjegyzed, hogy milyen meleg van kint. Azt beírod az első vonalra. Ma, hát ezt tegnap írtam ki, nem tudom, hogy milyen meleg volt ma, de én 45 fokot írtam be, süt a nap, és fúj a szél. Hát, Ez nem jött teljesen ki úgy, ahogy igazából a ma kiderült, mert nem fúj a szél, de később fog fújni, szóval így akkor meg lesz. De szóval reggel az első vonalba beírjuk, hogy milyen meleg van. Akkor a hőmérséklet, that's temperature, a hőmérséklet az mi. És akkor a süt a nap, felhős az ég, esik az eső, hull a hó, vagy fúj a szél. Ezeket akkor meg lehet mutatni, hogy milyen reggel az idő. Okay, so the next line is reggel, which is morning, right? You know that, reggel. And on that line, you'll write in the first space, you'll write what the temperature, the hőmérséklet is. So fok means degrees. So you'll write how many degrees it is in the morning when you wake up. And then you can also please make a note of what the weather conditions are like. What is the weather like? The first one, süt a nap. What does that mean? Süt a nap means that the sun is shining. You'll check that off if that is the case. The next one, felhős az ég. What does that mean? That means that the sky is cloudy. Next one, esik az eső. Do you know what that one means? That one means it is raining. The next one, hull a hó. This one must be easy because we've just went through winter. Hull a hó is the snow is falling. And then the last one, fúj a szél. The wind is blowing. Okay, so every morning after you write that top line, you write the date of the week and the date. Then you'll write in the morning, check the temperature. If you don't know the temperature, if that's too difficult to check, that's fine. Just try to do your best and fill out the rest. If it's sunny, go ahead and check that off. If it's very cloudy, then check the felhős az ég. If it's raining, if it's snowing, if it's windy, you check off all that apply. You'll do this for 3 times a day. You'll do this in the afternoon, and you'll do this in the evening as well. Most folytatjuk következő soron. Az első a vonalon azt írjuk, hogy hánykor keltem? Hány órakor keltem? Ezt is ki szeretném írni. Azt akarom, hogy írjátok ti is ki. Szóval nem a számot, nem hatos számot, hanem kiírjuk a szavat. Szóval 7-kor keltem. És hogyan aludtam? Azt is megjegyzem. Jól aludtam? Nem jól aludtam. Eleget aludtam? Úgy, ahogy akarod, beírod, hogy hogyan aludtál. És akkor a harmadik kis vonalon beírjuk, hogy miről álmodtam. Hogyha véletlenül álmodtál valamire, akkor azt beírjuk. Szóval én azt beírtam, hogy diákaimról álmodtam. Okay, so on the next line, what I'd like you to fill in, you have 3 sentences there. The first sentence is, what time did I wake up? So what I'm saying is, I woke at 7. 7-kor keltem. So, the next line, the next sentence, you will fill in the answer to the question, how did you sleep? Did you sleep well? I didn't sleep well. I slept enough. Whatever word, descriptive word, adjective that you want to use in there, you can to explain how you slept. I wrote, jól aludtam. I slept well. The third line is answering the question, what did I dream about? If you didn't dream about anything, if you don't remember your dream, you don't have to fill it in. You can also have fun with this. This is your journal. You're not going to be turning it into me. You're going to be filling the journal out for yourself. It's a really crazy time with a lot of changes, and I thought it would not only be helpful to study and practice Hungarian writing this way, but I think if you use the journal to practice and put into writing to record your experiences throughout your days, it might be really wonderful to save this for yourself when you're older so that you can look back on what you were doing at this age and during this time. So I wrote diákaim ról álmodtam, and that means I dreamt about my students because you're all always in my mind and in my heart. Okay, let's go on to the next section. Szóval ez a következő rész. A bal oldalon látjuk, hogy a fürdőszobában ott mit csináltam ma reggel a fürdőszobában. Vécéztem, kezet mostam, arcot mostam, megzuhanyoztam, fogat mostam, hajat fésülködtem, hát tükörbe bámultam, és még énekeltem. Hogyha valami mást is csináltál a fürdőszobában, ott is van a üres vonal, ott oda be lehet írni. So that next little section on the left is answering the question, what did you do in the bathroom this morning? Now I know this is a little private here. Again, as I said, this is just for your records. But again, just to practice, what are some of the things that we do our daily routines in the morning and in the bathroom? So, a fürdőszobában. Fürdőszoba is the bathroom. In the bathroom, vécéztem. I went to the bathroom. I went, number one or number two. That's what vécéztem means. Kezet mostam. I washed my hands. Now, of course, you wash your hands a number of times throughout the day, but just to practice that, kezet mostam. I washed my hands. Arcot mostam. I washed my face. Megzuhanyoztam. I showered. I took a shower. Fogat mostam. I brushed my teeth. You're actually saying mostam is I washed. So it's I washed my teeth, but I brushed my teeth. Hajat fésülködtem. I combed, I brushed my hair. Tükörbe bámultam. Oh, that's a, that, okay. I had to add in a couple of funny ones. Tükörbe bámultam means that, oh, I gazed into the mirror. Of course, we have to look into the mirror when we do our hygiene in the morning and throughout the day. But I kind of wrote it in an interesting way. But so if you've gazed into the mirror lovingly at yourself, always lovingly at yourself, tell yourself how amazing you are, how beautiful you are, how terrific you are, and what a great day you're going to have. Just know that is very true. Your reflection is very precious to many people who love you. So, and then the last option was énekeltem, which means I sang. So, and in the final blank line, if there's anything else that you'd like to record that you did in the bathroom in the morning, then you have the ability to write that in. Következő rész, most a jobb oldalán. Azt látjuk, hogy ott van egy üres hely, ahol be lehet írni, vagy, hogyha nem akarod beírni, akkor hát le lehet rajzolni. Azt csináljátok itt ebben a részben, amit akartok csinálni. De írd be, rajzold le, hogy mit csináltál reggel. Én azt írtam, hogy padlót mostam, írtam két oldalat, és kártyáztam férjemmel. Akkor ott az alján látunk még egy mondatot. Szóval valakit kisegítettem, amikor valamit csináltam. Szóval az első üres sorban beírtam, hogy barátnőmet. Barátnőmet segítettem, amikor felhívtam. Ezt azért szeretném, hogy beírjad valamit minden nap. Nem muszáj reggel, hogyha délután valami jóságot, kedvességet megtettél valaki másnak, hogyha kisegítettél valakit, anyukát, apukát, nővéret, öcsét, szomszédot, mindegy. Írd be, jegyezd meg, hogy mit csináltál, és minden nap próbálj egy jóságot valaki másnak megtenni. Jó? Nagyon jó. Okay, so the next section on the right is a blank area where I'd like you to either write out a few things that you've done in the morning, or if you don't want to write, you can draw something out. Make little notations of what you did in the morning. I wrote padlót mostam, that I washed my floors in the kitchen. I didn't write kitchen, but that's what padlót mostam means. I washed the floors. Írtam két oldalat. I wrote two pages. Kártyáztam férjemmel. I played cards with my husband, a card game that we like to do. And then on the bottom there, what you'll see is another sentence with two blanks, and I'd like you to write in the answer to the question, who and how did you help out somebody that day? Although that line, that sentence, is in the morning section, I'd like you to fill it out at any time. So if you've done one thing during the day to help somebody out, to do something for your mom or your dad, your brother, sister, or neighbors, please write it in there. Make a note of it. It doesn't have to be in the morning. It's any time throughout your day. And try to do one nice thing for somebody every day, and they will really appreciate it. So what I wrote was barátnőmet kisegítettem, amikor felhívtam. And what that means is, I helped out my girlfriend when I called her. Okay, let's move on to the next section. Délután. Ezen a soron még egyszer, ugyanúgy, mint reggel, beírjuk, hogy mennyi fok van, milyen meleg van, és milyen az idő. So the next section, délután, is just like the section above for morning, the morning section. You'll write in the temperature and what the weather is like. A következő soron azt írjuk be, hogy mikor ebédeltem. Fél egykor ebédeltem, azt írtam. So, fél egy is a fél egykor ebédeltem, és akkor a következő mondat azt szeretném, hogy azt írjuk be, hogy kivel ettem. Én a férjemmel ettem. Úgy is mondhatjuk persze, hogy ebédeltem. Az még helyesebb és pontosabb. Ebédeltem férjemmel, ebédeltem. Sajnos kihagytam, ott van a mondaton a vel meg val. Okay? Férjem el ettem, nincs ott V betű, de ezt csak úgy meg kell tanulni. Van, amikor ott van a V, van, amikor nincs. De a férjemmel ettem, ebédeltem. So on that next line, what you are answering is, what time did you have lunch? So fél egykor ebédeltem means I had lunch at 12:30. We're going to have to practice time and time telling, how to say time properly. There is a unique way that Hungarians say what time it is, and it can be very confusing. Even though I have been a Hungarian speaker all of my life, just like you guys, since it isn't all around us, you're not always hearing people talk about what time it is. Some of you may be just as confused as I can get sometimes. So, fél egy is, if you word for word translate what I'm saying in Hungarian, it means fél is half. It means half, 50%, half of something. Fél. And egy, of course, is one. So, what I'm actually saying in Hungarian is half one. Fél egy. Now, you might think that that means it's 1:30 because that's what we say. We say 1:30. Or in older days, we would say half past one, and that would be 1:30. But that's not what I'm saying here. Fail egg means 12:30. Okay, so you kind of have to back up in your mind, and when you're saying 12:30, what you're saying is fail egg, half of 1 o'clock. So that is just something that you'll have to learn. Do your best right now in filling it in, and in the coming weeks I will upload on Quizlet some practice on how to practice and how to say and write and tell time in Hungarian. But just do your best right now before we have that section. So the next line is answering the question, who did you eat with? Who did you have lunch with? And I wrote a férjemmel ettem. That means I ate with my husband. Now, I kind of messed up because when I wrote this down, I just have a férjem, which means my husband. And I didn't write the ending because, of course, if you look at that sentence, what I have, I've got the vel and the vol, which means with. Okay, that's the ending, the suffix that Hungarians use. But we don't always use the V. Okay, so vel and vol is like the word vele, which means with him, her, or it. Vele. But we use it on the end as well as a suffix as vel and vol, but we don't always use the V. Sometimes that V drops out, as when I say a férjemmel ettem. Okay, so I'm sorry I didn't write it in properly. We're going to all be making those little mistakes. It's just a way for us to continue to learn. So do your best there as well. Következő része a bal oldalán azt találjuk, hogy kint. Kint mit csináltam ma délután? Kint sétáltam, kint játszottam. Abban az üres vonalban, sorban oda beírhatjuk, hogy vagy mit játszottam, mennyi ideig játszottam, 30 percig játszottam, vagy a labdával játszottam, labdáztam. Szóval csak úgy be lehet gyorsan írni, hogyha meg akarod jegyezni, hogy hogyan játszottál. A üldögéltem, kirándultam. Mennyi állatot láttál? Én két állatot láttam ma És akkor beírtam ott az üres részben, hogy mókust és madarat láttam, dolgoztam, és akkor még egyszer ott van egy üres vonal, oda beírod, hogy mi mást csináltál kint. Minden nap nagyon-nagyon fontos, hogy kint legyünk, és pláne, hogyha napsütéses a nap, akkor jó esik, nem is csak a szívünk, meg lelkünknek, hanem testileg is nagyon-nagyon egészséges a nap. Minden nap 15 percet a napon kint lenni, ez nagyon-nagyon egészséges nekünk, a testünknek. Szóval tedd ezt meg. Okay, so the next section on the left, you'll see again some selections that you can check mark, and kint means outside. So you're answering the question here, what did you do outside this afternoon? Hopefully you did get out. It's very important for you to get out and get some fresh air, especially if it's sunny outside. It's not only good for our mood and for our spirit, to make us feel good to be outside in the sunshine, but it's actually really good physically as well. We get vitamin D through the sun, and so at least 15 minutes a day you should be out in the sunshine and playing, and hopefully a little bit more. So let's get back to what your selections are that you can check tick off. So sétáltam means I walked. I went for a walk. I went for a stroll. Játszottam. I played. I have a blank there so that you can put who, what you played outside, what kind of game you played. It's not a very big line, but if you want, you can write a little something in there. Üldögéltem, which is sat around. I just kind of, sat and relaxed in the sun. Or in the shade if you prefer. Kirándultam. Kirándultam is, camping. I kind of mean going out there and exploring. So kirándulás is exploring, going outside and, checking out what's going on with the ants or that are building their places, their little ant hills. Whatever, explore nature, go out and observe animals, which is the very next line. How many animals did you see while you were outside this afternoon? And I wrote in the blank space to the right, I wrote on the bottom there, you can say mókust és madarat láttam, which is I saw a squirrel and a bird. So you can do that as well. You can make notes in that blank section regarding on the left all of those different options that you have. The last one is dolgoztam. I worked outside. Kint dolgoztam. I worked outside. So you'll see all of those make sentences. As I've just said, kint dolgoztam. I worked outside. You're really saying, obviously, outside, I worked. But kint dolgoztam, I worked outside. Kint sétáltam, I walked outside. I went for a walk outside, etc. And then, of course, you have a blank there again to fill in with whatever else, other type of activity you did outside. The important thing is if the weather allows for you to get outside every day for a little bit of nature. Nature is very restorative. Don't be afraid of nature. We don't live hundreds and hundreds and thousands of years ago as tribes out in the woods. We don't have that difficult of a life in our culture and our lifestyle where we're inside a lot in these wonderful homes that shelter us. But it's just as necessary and just as important for us to be outside, outdoors as well. And thank God it's springtime, so we can definitely get enough time outdoors. Okay, so then what you'll see in that next section on the right is the same thing that you did above. Just what did you do in the afternoon? Go ahead and list it. So én a jobb oldalán azt írtam, beírtam, hogy mit csináltam délután. Délután írtam még három oldalt, növényet ültettem, sétáltam 15 percig, és úgy már említettem, hogy mókust és madarat láttam. What I wrote in that section is írtam még három oldalt. I wrote another three pages. Növényet ültettem. I planted plants. And of course, that'll be an activity in your box. You received some bulbs that you will be planting, some onion and garlic bulbs, garlic cloves. And so we'll talk about that later date. Sétáltam 15 percig. So that means I went for a walk. I strolled for 15 minutes. And then, as I've already mentioned, mókust és madarat láttam. I saw a squirrel and a bird. Ott a pirosban azt olvashatjuk, hogy ma magyarul. Ma magyarul mit csináltam? Még egyszer, nem kell, hogy ezt délutánban csináld meg, hogyha reggel magyarul írtál, gyakoroltál, és persze, hogyha ezt a naplót tartod, akkor írsz, magyarul fogsz írni minden nap, ezt mindig is akkor meg lehet ott jegyezni, hogy ma magyarul írtam, ma magyarul olvastam, ma magyarul énekeltem. Serkenj fel! És ma magyarul Quizleten gyakoroltam. Okay, so the next little area over there in red, you'll see ma magyarul. And that means that today in Hungarian, and you will make a note of what did you do in Hungarian today. Again, this is not necessarily applying to the afternoon. It means for the whole day. What did you do today? In Hungarian. And of course, you're always going to check off ma magyarul írtam because what you're saying is today I wrote in Hungarian. And as you are keeping this daily journal and writing in it, you're always going to have that checked off. Nice, right? Yes. How about the next one? Ma magyarul olvastam. Now, this does not mean that you read your daily journal pages. What this means is that you actually sat down and did a little bit of reading. It would be really good, again, if you can find in your day 15 minutes a day to do a little bit of Hungarian reading. When I was your age, my dad, oh boy, he actually would come home from work and he would have my sisters and I take turns and read to him out loud. And it was really interesting because I have memories of being wherever my dad was. So if there was a project in the basement that he was working on, he would have us come down and do his he would be doing his work, and we would either sit or stand there and read in Hungarian to him. I don't know if I want to give your parents that idea, but I'm just trying to say that that does help. It is important for you to read every day. So ma magyarul olvastam, ma magyarul énekeltem. Oh, today I sang in Hungarian. You know, singing is very, very important to our spiritual, our feeling of being uplifted. Music is so soothing, it's so uplifting, it's so important for us as human beings. You know, that separates us from animals, right? That we can speak and sing, although birds can sing, and I'm not taking away anything from the birds. But anyway, if you can sing a song in Hungarian every day, a little bit, learn a song. I'll try to upload some more songs for you in Hungarian so that you have options to at least listen to Hungarian music. But if you do that, then you can check that off. And then the last option I have there, ma magyarul Quizleten gyakoroltam. And that means that today I practiced Quizlet in Hungarian. And I hope that you do take at least 15 minutes a day as well to go over to that area and just practice some of those flashcards and do some of those little tests and activities that they have there for you. There'll be more things that I upload there for you to choose from. Thanks for your patience. I forgot to provide a line. If you do something else in Hungarian, make a project or something that's revolved with Hungarian, you can certainly make a note and jot it down for yourself. Az utolsó része este. Most már megérkezett az este, és most már mi történt az időjárással? Milyen fajta az idő van? Lehűlt az idő? Beborult az ég, mi történt? És ezt megjegyezzük itt. Persze este nem süt a nap itt nálunk, a földnek a másik oldalán süt a nap, de a hold kijön. Igen, van, amikor nagyon-nagyon fényes a hold, és akkor azt beírtam, hogy holdfényes idő. Okay, so on that next section, the last section, is este, which is evening. And again, you'll make notes of what's the weather like? Did the temperature go down? And of course, the sun is no longer shining in the evening. It's set. The sun has set. Of course, it's shining on the other side of the world, but now the moon has come out. So if it's a clear night, I put in, an option for you to check off hold fényes, which is it's the moonlight is shining. If you can see the stars outside, etc. A következő két mondat, még egyszer ugyanúgy, ahogy ebédkor megjegyezzük, hogy hány órakor ettünk, még egyszer megjegyezzük, hogy hánykor vacsoráztam. Én 6-kor vacsoráztam. Jó étvágyat! Mindenkinek jó étvágyat! És akkor azt szeretném, a következő a mondatot azt írjuk be, hogy hány óra volt, amikor szabad voltam, szabad időm van most este. 7 órától szabad időm volt. The next line has, just as we did for lunchtime, I'd like you to write in what time you had dinner. Hatkor vacsoráztam. I had dinner, I ate dinner at 6 o'clock. Hatkor vacsoráztam. Jó étvágyat. What does jó étvágyat mean? I'm sure you know that. It means have a good appetite. It's like the French say bon appétit, bon appétit. We say jó étvágyat. In English, we don't really, we don't really wish others, I'm trying to think of what we might say. All right, everybody eat. But jó étvágyat is what we say in Hungarian. And then the next sentence, you're again going to fill out a time, and this is 7 órától szabad időm volt. And what that means is from 7 o'clock, I had free time. So once you're done with dinner and all of your other activities, dinner, all of your daily activities, when did you finally have free time? So you can write that in there. És alatta a következő részén, a baloldali részén, akkor azt találjuk, hogy a házban mit csináltál este? A házban tévéztem, a házban valamit olvastam, beírhatod, hogy mit olvastál. A házban valamit játszottam, a házban videójátékoztam, a házban művészkedtem, és még egyszer az üres vonalon oda beírhatjuk, hogy ha valami mást, másfajta szórakozással foglalkoztam, beírhatjuk. All right, that next section on the left, you'll see that a házban. And a házban means in the house. Remember that ban ending? So a házban, in the house, what did you do? Tévéztem. I watched TV. Olvastam. I read something. Again, you have a line, you can put something in there. If you want, you can put magyarul olvastam. Könyvet olvastam. So I read in Hungarian, or I read a book. Or magazint olvastam. I read a magazine. Whatever it is. You can make a note if you'd like. Játszottam. I played. What did you play? I played a board game with my family. Whatever it is that you played. I played ball. Labdát játszottam. So you can just make those notes yourself. Videójátékoztam. I played video games. Művészkedtem. I did some painting or some artwork or some craft. Művészkedtem. And then if none of those apply, go ahead and fill in something yourself. What did you do inside the house in the evening? És akkor még egyszer, ugyanúgy, ahogy reggel és délután, beírjuk este, hogy a lefekvés ideig ezzel szórakoztam. So, until the time, bedtime, until bedtime, I was busy doing this. This is what I, entertained myself with. And what I wrote down is, megnéztem a King and I filmet, férjemmel, miután asztalt leszettem és elmosogattam. Wow! I wrote this long sentence there, so let me say it one more time. Megnéztem a King and I filmet, férjemmel, miután asztalt leszettem és elmosogattam. So I watched the King and I film with my husband and cleaned the table off and washed the dishes. I hope you have something more exciting that you'll write in there. I'm just kidding. I love the King and I. If you have an opportunity, kids, watch some of these great classic movies from the 50s and 60s. They are some wonderful films. I'm not saying that today's films aren't, but these are really some wonderful films. The King and I and Oklahoma. If you like musicals, so many of you play musical instruments that I think that you must love music. So some of these great movies, I hope that you're able to watch some of those with your family. Végre az alján mindig lesz egy pár mondat, amelyeket a napunk végén átgondoljuk, hogy milyen napunk volt, és ezeket leírjuk. Az első üres vonalon azt írjuk be, hogy mi a legjobb dolog, ami ma történt. Azt beírjuk. So, on the bottom, what you'll find is you're going to have a couple of sentences that you have to fill in and make a note of your day. You'll reflect, think back on your day, and find your answers that way. You'll reflect on how your day was, and you'll make notes of it. So the first sentence, that first blank line, you'll write in that blank line, Ez a legjobb dolog, ami ma történt. This is the best thing that happened today. So you'll write something in there. I wrote, egészséges vagyok. I'm healthy. That's the best thing that happened today. Actually, that is always, every day, the best thing that happens every day, that we have our health and have our family and have our life to learn and grow and play and even worry sometimes and be afraid. All of those human experiences are great blessings. Always be patient with yourself, always be kind with yourself, and allow yourself to experience all of those ups and downs of being a human being. And when you have something wonderful happen in your day, that's what I'd like you to write down there. What is the best thing that happened to you today? You'll write it in there. A következő mondat, holnap ezt szeretném csinálni. És én beírtam, hogy barátnőmmel sétálni. And the last sentence there will answer the question, what would you like to do tomorrow? Holnap ezt szeretném csinálni. Tomorrow, I'd like to do this. So I wrote in, barátnőmmel sétálni. To go for a walk with my girlfriend. Az oldal alján itt van a három szó, amit ma megtanultam. És persze ez magyar szóról van szó. Szóval, mi az a három szó, amit ma megtanultam? Én három szavat, hát én itt egy kicsit csaltam. Csalóka vagyok, csaló vagyok, hát igen. Mert ezeket a szavakat már ismerem, már tudom, de én azt írtam, hogy szeretem a diákomat. Ti három szavat leírtok, amit ma remélem megtanultátok. Okay, on the very, very bottom, the last line has, the three words that you've learned today. And of course, this means Hungarian words. So you'll write in the three words that you learned. And of course, the three words that I wrote down, I already know these three words, so I'm a little bit of a cheater. But I wrote szeretem a diákomat. And that means I love szeretem a the diákomat, my students. And I do. I love you all. Take care of yourselves. Do your best with this journal, the journaling exercise. I will post another journaling, your fitness journal tips to do that. But right now, just focus on this for now. You have 5 weeks of journal pages. Your fitness pages, I've only given you 4 weeks. So focus on the daily journal to begin with, and next week we will tackle and prepare ourselves to also incorporate the fitness journal. You're welcome to begin the fitness journal this week if you'd like. And then, you know, I think I've sent the PDF. It's available at the Google Classroom, and it's also sent to your mom and dad. So you can print up an extra week if you want to do that. But this week, focus on filling out as best you can your daily journal every day. Okay, good luck with it. Jó szerencsét, and take care of yourselves, okay? Bye. Sziasztok.